Good day, this is Reverend Lenny Zaguirre, the head pastor of the Living Epistle Church here in Quezon City. After much prayer, I wanted to encourage everyone, all the pastors, all the members of the church, all the churches, and how I can encourage every one of you, but not in a way that is falsely grounded in our current realities na hindi po nakaugat sa mga nangyayari sa kapanahunang ito. So, sa Mateo Kapitulo 1, Versikulo 23, may isa pong anghel na namusap po kay Jose, and the angel declared that the people will call Jesus Emmanuel, God with us. But for Joseph, it never felt like God was with him. And maybe for some of you, you pastors, you members, you leaders of the church, maybe you cannot claim Matthew chapter 1, verse 23, that God is with us. You know, for Joseph, he finds out that Mary was pregnant. For Joseph, being just a just man, isang tuwid pong lalaki, at ayaw niya pong may pahiya po ito pong si Maria, he was planning to divorce Mary quietly. At kung hindi po niya inangkin po ang batang dinadala po ni Mary, she would be stoned to death. But if he claimed to be the father of the baby that Mary was carrying, people will be talking behind his back. So when they went to Bethlehem, no, nung alam pa po natin ang kwentong ito, that when Mary and Joseph went to Bethlehem for the census, there was no available room. Think about this. Most of the residents in Bethlehem were Joseph's relatives, but Joseph felt that he was rejected. Joseph witnessed how his family and his newborn boy stayed in a stable. And then after Jesus was born, his family had to flee. Kailangan pong tumakas po papuntang Egypto dahil po sa banta, because of the threat of Herod, because he was looking for Jesus to kill the baby Jesus. So the angel said to Joseph, you know, that Jesus is going to be called Emmanuel, God with us. But all this time, like what I said, it never felt to Joseph that God was with him and his family. No, Joseph was exposed to embarrassment for having a pregnant fiance. No, meron po siyang fiance, pero hindi pa po niya pwede pong mabuntis. No, kasi hindi pa po talaga sila officially pong consummated po yung kasal. But Mary was pregnant, so he was exposed to embarrassment. Joseph felt rejected when there was no room in Bethlehem. He was rejected by most of his relatives when Mary gave birth. Joseph and his family felt threatened when Herod was looking for the child Jesus. But still, Jesus is Emmanuel. He was with Joseph and Mary all this time, much as it appeared that Jesus cannot do anything because he appeared like a helpless baby. But through God's guidance, through the angels and dreams, they survived. I think with everything Joseph and Mary was going through and experienced, they grew to love the baby more. They bonded. They felt a connection. They were mommy and daddy to this helpless boy. My prayer is that with everything you might be going through during this pandemic season, you will be guided by God and His angels. When everything becomes really tough, difficult, and unbearable, nahihirapan ka na ba? Like Joseph and Mary, may Jesus be with you all this time. May He still be Emmanuel. Despite the difficulties, He is with us. Maybe it's hard. Maybe life, for some of you, you can say it's great. But whatever you are going through today, you will grow to love the baby more. But now, He is not a baby. That you will grow to love Jesus more. That this COVID-19 pandemic will be the catalyst, something that will urge you, that will stir up, that you and me will draw more closer to the Lord Jesus Christ. My prayer is that you will bond with the divine, that you will feel a connection with the Word. Jesus is that Word, according to John chapter 1. And that you will feel that Jesus is a brother and a friend, that He is really someone close to your heart. My prayer is that you will come out, and I will come out stronger, knowing that God is with us. May you have an awesome Christmas and a fantastic New Year. This is Pastor Glenn Isagire praying that Jesus really will be